You don't have to be a new mom to understand that when children enter your life, it's, A, very busy, and B, usually mom does most of the heavy lifting, especially in the early years, for obvious reason, to the point where mom may neglect some of the needs that she has for herself, which is why Mom's Got Game and a new program that is recruiting specifically new moms that is hoping to remind mom that she matters too. Let's talk about it. We have Dr. Corliss Bean, researcher, assistant professor of recreation and leisure studies at Brock, and Kim Girdler, director of operations and outreach at the Sport Information Resource Center. Good morning to both of you.
Good morning.
Kim, I appreciate it. This is an important issue because, as I said, you know, sometimes, I'll speak as a son, mom put me first. And as a result, we have to remind mom that she matters too in terms of, big picture health, mental health, and so on. So, Kim, first and foremost, let's begin with Mom's Got Game, and this is the second year, and you're sort of reminding new moms or introducing new moms to this. Why that group?
Well, you know what? The pandemic, as we know, has been incredibly difficult on everyone, every Canadian. But what we've noticed with the research is that new moms in particular have been hit really hard. Like, it's hard when you're a new mom, when you can't get out as much. You don't have the same drop in groups and social activities that you would have had. So you tend to spend a lot more time at home with your baby. But it's really important for new moms to get out, get moving, get active, make those connections that really help them be better moms in the end.
Dr. Bean, what happens if they don't? What are some of the consequences of not, you know, reminding yourself that it's important to remain active?
Yeah, that's a great question. I think it's really important to recognize that the mental health aspect and the mental health benefit of being physically active. And one of the big things that we always remind new moms is that the importance of being kind to yourself and having that notion of self-compassion. So recognizing that there are a lot of challenges out there. And if we don't become physically active or remain physically active, then not only does mom's health suffer, but also the family unit health also suffers.
As part of your research, you ever look at the effects of physical activity, time for mom, specifically in terms of when it comes to postpartum depression, for example, and how it helps fight that or minimize that at all?
Yeah, absolutely. There's a lot of research out there to promote physical activity and how that can help combat postpartum depression. And a lot of what we've seen recently is the importance of getting out in the connection with nature. So being in green space, whether that's going for a hike, just getting outdoors and engaging with nature is a really benefit thing that we've heard a lot from our moms when we have interviewed them. Just making sure that connection, again, it's not only just that physical health benefit, but that mental health benefit as well.
How physical, how active, how often should they be doing something?
Physical activity guidelines recommend anywhere from around 150 moderate to vigorous minutes of physical activity per week. What's important to remember for moms is it doesn't matter when this takes place or in what size chunks. So getting out for a 10-minute walk, a 15-minute walk, doing things in small, manageable chunks, making sure that it's adaptable and flexible to both your needs but also your baby's needs is really important. So every little bit helps, and never too little and never too late to start.
I know, Kim, that Dr. Bean and a colleague has put together a very important guidebook that kind of spells it out, and also you're recruiting new moms. Talk specifically, if anyone's listening and says, hey, I want to know more, where do they go?
Well, they can go to the website. They go to circ.ca/momsgotgame, and in there they'll find all kinds of research-based information to help them get started. And as you mentioned, the new guidebook that Corliss and Dr. Iris Lesser created is really an excellent starting point for those new moms that just don't know how to start. How will my body react to exercise? What are some of the things I should do? And to emphasize Corliss' point about being good to yourself as a mom, because there's so much that they need to do and to be on top of, and exercise is one more thing, but it doesn't need to be an extra stressor. It's just something for them to consider that can really benefit them in the long run. But the website has tons of great information for new moms and every mom.
I want to repeat the website. It's circ.ca, circ with an S, circ.ca/momsgotgame. Appreciate it. Dr. Bean, Kim, thank you.
Thank you very much. Bye.
Bye-bye. It's 10 o'clock, time for Chris's News. News Talk 580 CFRA.